प्रोफेसर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड टेलीकम्युनिकेशन इंजीनियरिंग वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी सोलापुर. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस फ्रेम रिले नेटवर्क लर्निंग आउटकम. एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू डिस्क्राइब की फीचर्स ऑफ फ्रेम रिले नेटवर्क. कंटेंट्स इन द फॉलोइंग स्लाइड्स we will consider different features of frame relay, virtual circuit used in the frame relay, and congestion control. Let us see the frame relay. This is what figure 1 indicates X.25 network, and figure 2 indicates frame relay network. As we see, there are different nodes are there, and these nodes are connected with each other for transferring data between any given node to any other node. But in frame relay, these nodes are connected to the frame relay network, and the transferring of data from a particular DTE to another DTE is done by the frame relay network. So here, if you look at X.25 is a point-to-point network communication. So if there are 5 nodes, as we see here, which wants to communicate with each other, it will require 10 different links. These are the 10 different links between nodes. This is avoided in a frame relay network. As we see here, these nodes are not connected. In a frame relay network itself does the task of switching from a particular DTE to another DTE. So as we see, each DTE is connected to a DCE, and the frame relay network does the remaining thing for us. Here figure 3 and figure 4 shows what type of data a particular network supports. For example, this supported by X.25, and this type of data is supported by frame relay. So here, if you look at this, on x-axis we have time and on y-axis we have data rate, and this nature of data is constant here, and this type of data is supported by X.25, whereas in this data is not constant. At some point in time there is a data, in another time there is no data, and third time a huge amount of data. That means this type of data rate, or this pattern of data rate, is called bursty nature of data. And this X.25 does not support this, because it is designed to communicate data rate of, that is, constant data rate, whereas frame relay supports this bursty nature of data by using the buffering technique. Another feature is, in X.25, in addition to data packets, many packets have to be transferred, and that increases the load on the network. But in frame relay, there is no necessity of transferring other packets, because the links are more reliable, and that's why flow and error control is not required in frame relay. But because of higher speed in frame relay, a congestion may occur, and that's why it is necessary to perform congestion control in frame relay. Here, if you look at, this is figure number 5 of X.25. These are the different layers present in the X.25. And this is figure number 6, frame relay. These are the 2 layers present in the frame relay. So if you look at this, to perform data transfer in frame relay requires only 2 layers, whereas in X.25 it requires 3 layers. Now let us have a question. Why congestion control is needed in frame relay? You pause the video and answer the question. You might have thought over the question. Congestion control is needed in frame relay because the data is transferred at a very high rate. Now let us study this virtual circuit. Virtual circuits are of two types. One is a permanent virtual circuit and another is a switched virtual circuit. If you look at this frame format of a frame relay network, we have flags in the beginning and at the end, then address information, control information, information to be transmitted. So we have this address information is shown here in detail. There are different bits are used for congestion control. For example, DLCI, this first bit, it is called Data Link Connection Identifier, which is used for congestion control. Another bit, C/R, that is Command/Response. Then EA, Extended Address. Then FECN, BECN. FECN stands for Forward Explicit Congestion Notification, and BECN stands for Backward Explicit Congestion Notification. These two bits are also used for congestion control. And this DE is used for discard eligibility. So this is what the frame format of frame network, which is used for congestion control. Now let us see DLCI. In PVC, DLCI are permanent and assigned by the network provider, whereas in SVC, switched virtual networks, DLCIs are temporary and assigned by the frame relay during the connection phase. Let us have a look at figure 8, how congestion control is done in a frame relay. Here, this is a node, so, DTA, this is a DTB, and these two DTs want to communicate with each other, and there are different nodes, communication network nodes are present. There are 5 nodes total, and at each node, we can have a table of DLCIs. So this is a input DLCI's number and this is an output DLCI number. For example, here we have expanded this one, node 2 of the network, where 1 is an input node, this one, this is an input node, and other 2 are output node numbered as 2 and 3. If you look at this table, this is input 1, this is an input 1. And when the output is 2, that means if there is a connection between 1 and 2, then DLCI assigned to input is 48, this one. So this DLCI assigned to this input is 48. And the DLCI assigned to output is 65, as we see here. But if the connection is between 1 and 3, DLCI changes. So the DLCI is 62 assigned for the input and 98 assigned for the output, that means here, 3. So this way, virtual circuits are created and DLCI are assigned. Congestion control. Because of higher data rate and no use of flow control, frame relay network is prone to congestion. It uses two bits for congestion control, that is BECN and FECN, and discard eligibility bit is used for packet discarding whenever other things do not work. Here we can have the table. The two bits are 0, 0, that means there is no congestion. When there is a 0, 1, there is a congestion in one direction. When it is 1, 0, the congestion is in other direction. And when both are 1, the congestion is in both the directions. So we can find out what type of congestion is occurred between using these two bits. Now, how to find out that congestion has taken place? For that, what is necessary is we should perform traffic control measurements, and that is done in the next slide. Here, these are the different parameters for congestion control. One is the access rate. Then there is a committed bus size, BC, committed information rate, and excess bus size. So when access rate is beyond a particular value, then we can say that there is a congestion. Here also the bus size is also, if it is greater than BC, that is predefined maximum bits per second, then we can say the congestion is occurred. Here, this is the average information rates in bits per second. And this is what the excess bus size means. If the maximum number of bits per second exceeds this BC, then congestion may occur. These are the references. Data Communication by Professor Ajit Pal, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Indian Institute of Technology, Kharagpur. And I have taken the contents from NPTEL lecture number 24 on X.25 and frame delay. You can go through this link for additional information. Thank you very much.